Welcome back to the Talos Principle. We have a couple more puzzles to solve in here, although I suspect we have many more that aren't officially designated puzzles. The whole thing with the boxes and this over here and that ladder. I mean, that ladder isn't there for no reason.
I see you sticking over there, ladder piece.
So, something more is obviously going on. There's gotta be a way to get on the walls. But for now, let's just finish the designated puzzles. Third wheel. Okay, so red power to open this, get another connector, and that allows me access to blue power. Blue power goes over here, that gives me access to this, then I need something to weigh that down to get to the piece. And there's the red power. I'm just looking for ways up on these walls. But these walls are relatively high, actually. Anyway, okay, so let's get this going. So, red power is here. That gets that open, then... Oh, I see. Alright, so that's gonna mess that up. It actually gets some blue power for a little bit. But anyway, we need to put this further out. There we go. Well, that's pretty neat. Making some shapes. That was extremely easy to solve. Ah, we now have access to the fan. And no, I have not forgotten about the 10 stars that I have, by the way. When I'm finished with this zone, I'm going to take that back to the original zone and go see what's in there. Yeah, guess that's it. Road of Death. Alright, so there's a force field over there somewhere. Looks like we gotta snake around. Gotta go through the Road of Death and come out the other end. Oh my god. Okay, so can I make it explode one of the turrets? Suppose that's an important question. That's a very low window, and I have access to a box. Yes, these are very low windows. I think I can jump out those. Run off into the desert. Alright, let's see if the turrets will even allow me to get near it. Yep, they do. Alright, this seems too easy though. So what's gonna happen? Right, it doesn't actually get close enough. And what's up here? Okay, so I can just bypass the whole thing. So then what am I trying to... Oh, I'm trying to get the box to the other side. That's what I'm trying to do. Yeah. Epitaph, child program, blah blah blah, codename Samsara terminated here. Logic, program timed out. Final memory dump. But I was stuck. What was I supposed to... I see clouds. Oh yeah, and look at this. It says Progeny Program Samsara version 7.2 series. And this is an epitaph for version 7.2.1. So Progeny Program. Yeah, so after this one died, it spawned... It generated another one based on the previous one. So yeah, this is some sort of a forced, like, hyper-sped-up evolution sort of thing, with mutations and carrying on your genetic information, so to speak. Okay, so what am I actually going to do here? Well, I don't necessarily need the box, actually. Actually, I have an idea. But first, let me just test this. So I can't actually take this up a ladder with me, right? That's a problem? Okay. And I can't reach down far enough to grab one of these things, but what if I put it on a box? I could probably reach that, right? Yeah. Well, that was easy. I mean, I don't even need to weigh it down. I could just do this. Okay, so I think this is the room where I can do some weird stuff. I think I can get out the windows, assuming I can fit. I can't actually get this back there with me, though, can I? No. Let me restart checkpoint. Yeah, so I still have the shape, but all these things have reset. So go ahead and give me that, thank you. Let me see if I can pop out of here. Son of a bitch. It's like a centimeter too small. Oh, what do you bet there's a special window that's just slightly bigger than the others? And of course, I can't crouch. So now I just need to find the one, huh? I'll try them all if that's what it takes. Those assholes. Those freaking assholes. And I really can't crouch. God, I'm like the least adaptable robot ever. I hope my progeny program can friggin' crouch. Those are too high up, I think. Yeah, those are way too high up. Hmm. Let me try the windows on the other side. Wait, actually, can I get the box across? I don't know if I can get the box across. I can set the jammer on top of the box, but I can't set the box on top of the jammer. One thing I could do with this, however, is if I was able to find my way outside there another way, I could perhaps put the jammer here and then, like, grab the jammer through the window. So this could be a way of getting this outside of this room, getting the jammer outside, jailbreaking the jammer. Maybe. Is there really no way to get that box over there? This one's kind of cockeyed. Is there any way I can move this damn thing to make it go to one of the guns and explode? Would it even matter? You know, it actually would. If I can get this thing to go over to the left here and explode both of these that are clustered. Actually, no, there's two on the other side. It wouldn't matter. Never mind. There's something going on here. There's something with the freaking boxes. Technically, the puzzles in this place are complete, but there's no way. There's more. Especially here. That's the spot that has the ladder on the other side. Just taunting me, even though there doesn't actually appear to be anything here. Even if I was able to get through here. And if I got out here, I could get out into the desert and go grab the jammer. Although I don't know how grabbing the jammer would help me in any way. Maybe I need to get one of the boxes outside and then use that to get in? In one of these windows here? If only I can get on top of this computer. Yeah, I don't know. There's definitely something more going on here. I have not finished this place, by no means. I'm gonna do some more exploration of this, and I'll be right back. Okay, I found a possible entry point to do crazy stuff. So I finally found a way to get somewhere up, and that's here. This is for one of those puzzles that I already solved. So you can get up here. Which, as you can see around, if you're used to the game at all, then this looks like a playground of possible ways to break the game. Look at all the things to jump on. Okay, so I can jump on that. But there's no point, because that doesn't allow me to get anywhere. I can't make it straight over. I didn't even jump that time. I can't quite reach it just by jumping straight. However, I did just find something out, and that's that I can jump on top of force fields. Also, do you see something on the screen? You see that? In the sand? There's an object buried in the sand. I thought maybe it's just random refuse, you know, just debris that's out there, but look out there. There's nothing. There's no debris, there's no random black things in the sand. That's the only thing. That is something. It almost looks like it's maybe like another robot or something buried, or maybe a computer or something. It looks electronic. Like, I see a blue glow. But anyway, I think if I jump just right, probably not here because the palm tree's in the way, but maybe if I jump this way, I might be able to make it. Oh crap, I gotta go all the way back to the beginning. If I reset, does that reset at the checkpoint? It's probably quicker just to do this. I guess, well, hold on, let me try holding X. Actually, I'm scared. I don't want to do that. I'm worried it might reset everything. No, it won't. Okay, yeah, just to the last checkpoint. Okay, and just to be sure, this doesn't have any boxes, right? I believe it's just connectors in this place. Yeah, connector. I'm also looking for other possible ways to jump up on something. Whoa, I never saw this before. Or maybe I did. I don't know, nothing back there. I want to jump up into one of these statues' laps. Alright, so yeah, nothing there. I don't know if this jump is possible, actually. I think it might be at too extreme of an angle. But there's definitely something out there. Because if I hit this, I'm going to bounce off, and that's going to ruin my chances. So I actually have to jump off before I hit the edge. Alright, one more try, and then I'll cut out my attempts until I actually do it, or am convinced of its impossibility! I'm just gonna invent that word, because it sounds cool. Oh, so close! Okay, I'll be back in a second. Oh! It's funny, I did it on the very first attempt that I made after I cut. I made it outside. Yes. What are you? Whoa. That's a helmet. Robots don't need helmets. That's a person's helmet. Or something. What does it say? There's like initials or something on that? What does that say? Is that J-A-U? I wish I could zoom in more. I'm not sure what the first letter is. But after that, after the first letter, it's definitely A-U. What is that first letter? Is it like reversed or something? UAC? Why would it be reversed, though? Hold on, let me check the team leads. Anybody with... possible initials like that? Anybody with initials like AU? No, no, no. Aurora Kelvin? Well, it could be a C. It does kind of look like a C. That has the A and the C, but I don't know about the U. That person's name isn't even there. If it was Aurora Kelvin, then it would be Link Hardware. So it'd be A something C. Maybe? I don't know. I mean, is that just a helmet, or is there actually a person buried down there? I want to dig. But I don't think I can. And then there's like some writing right underneath those initials or whatever that is, but I can't read it. I think it's just gibberish. Can't dig? Nope. That is freaking creepy. That is really creepy. Just buried in the sand. But buried in the sand of a, what I presume is a simulation. What the hell did I just do on my desk? I just pulled down a bunch of papers with my foot. There we go. Yeah, this is creepy. If that's a person, how is there a person in the simulation? Like, what does that mean? They can't physically be here, right? Unless this isn't actually a simulation. But this has to be a simulation, right? I mean, how could this not be a simulation with the stuff that's happening? Teleporters and stuff? Whoa. Oh god, I just get deeper and deeper into the sand as I go. Alright, well, I don't want it to kill me and undo everything, so let's just skirt around and see if there's anything particularly interesting. So now I have access to all those windows. Which means I could go get that... The jammer. So I'm just gonna look around the outskirts first, and then I'm gonna look about poking inside. Well, actually, we might as well do both at the same time. So if I was to just, like, jump through here, well, I can't even fit, so who cares? Yeah, I can't fit through any of these. Don't kill me. Don't kill me. I might be getting too far out. Oh, I don't think I can keep going this direction. Alright, let's go the other way. Nothing hidden in the cracks, right? Nope. You know, I wonder if this is the person. Remember, you're my eyes and ears out here? Sam or Sarah or whoever it was on the walkie-talkie. And they're talking about the riddle of the Sphinx. I wonder if that's one of those people. Prime territory for hiding a walkie-talkie or something like that. No. Hold on. I'm going to try to go back up there again, but just want to take a look around first. See if there's anything particularly interesting on the ground. See if there's any other buried treasure. Can't quite fit through that one, almost. Alright, let's jump back up on here. I'm actually a little bit worried about getting stuck in here. Because if I have to reset, I'm gonna have to make that jump again. Ooh! I just realized what this gave me access to! Do you see what I see? I see beauty. I see a sexy wall that I want to climb all over and caress with my robot feet. I want to give that wall a foot job. But first, let's look for any floppies full of kitten pictures or anything like that. Okay. Before I start working on the inside, let's keep going around the outside. I have the star, so anything I'm doing is not in pursuit of trying to get the star, so I need to keep that in mind. So I'm just looking for secret stuff, walkie-talkies, etc., etc.
The beginning were the words, and the words made the world.
Oh shit.
I am the words, the words
are. Alright, I don't think I can go around that corner. Okay. In that case, it's time to jump on the wall and let's see what we can do. So not looking for stars, just looking for secrets. Oh. Oh. Beautiful. Oh, you know what? There could be stuff on top of these pillars. What do you bet? Gotta keep an eye out for floppy disks and stuff like that. Yes, any one of these could have something on top of it. Ooh. The possibilities boggle the mind! I can't jump to the other side, though, and if I go down there, I can't get back up. So, let's go this direction. That's red power. Yeah, it's nothing interesting. I love that you can just break this game like this. It's awesome. Alright, so I can get on the wall here. I don't think that helps me, though. Because unfortunately, I can't go this way. Hmm. This might be the end of my grand journey on the wall. I mean, okay, I could get on that wall, and that could take me... I could follow that around, sure, sure. Is that gonna take me back up, though? I don't think so. No, I don't believe it will. I really want to just get to the other side. I could try going around the corner. Maybe if I go around the corner, the world won't quite end. Maybe. I mean, if it's not that, then where else could I possibly go? Alright, let's try going out there. Maybe it won't quite be out of bounds. I mean, there's a puzzle room right there, so I might be okay.
The beginning were the words, and the words made the world.
Ooh.
I am the words.
Okay, okay. It's alright. Excellent, excellent. So this is that room. This might kill me, though. Come on, don't. Okay. We're fine. We're fine. There's an inside to that place. I'm gonna check that out in a second. Don't kill me. Don't kill me. There's nothing in here. Can I make it around the corner? We're gonna try. Don't kill me, please! Oh. Okay, so this is where I think, if I hadn't have reset stuff, or maybe I... Yeah, if I had actually placed stuff, I think I could probably grab the jammer through the window. But of course, there's no actual reason to do that at the moment. Unless I have something to unjam, which I don't. My feet keep sinking in the sand. Alright, so this is the puzzle room where those two boxes were. Not sure if there's a reason for me to go up there. Keep looking on top of stuff for floppy disks. Alright, that's the room where the ladder is. Another window I can't fit through. Whoa! It's the first window I've been able to fit through. It's a miracle. Although it's one way, evidently. Okay, well, I'm not getting the out of bounds thing. So I can safely explore this stuff. Oh, that's a puzzle room. Right. Crap, it's a dead end. Alright, let's see if we can go around. I'm surprised I'm not finding secrets here. Practically made a full circuit of this place. And I still haven't realized my dream of floating a box on water. This is very disappointing. I still have no idea how to get a box into the water. I know I can get a jammer outside, but who cares about that? Shit. Yeah, that's it. Huh. Maybe the one helmet was it? I feel like there's probably more, though. Maybe that was it. Well, at least I know how to get outside, and I can jump on the wall a bit. Poor bastard. I guess that's it for this place. Let's take one more quick look at jumping up there. Any other pathways I can take? Anything I could use to get to the other side. Not that that really matters that much. Anything I could use to grab a box. I need to get to the other side if I want to grab a box, though, because all the boxes are on the other side. That's the thing. Alright, let's crawl along here. See if this takes me anywhere. Oh no, this is a dead end. Okay. I guess we're done here. Got the star, got all the pieces? Yeah. Okay, let's go unlock the fan. And then, of course, the stars. But first, the fan. So it's time to go. Did I just see something? No, I think it's just a light. I thought maybe I saw a ladder or something down there. Like midway through the shaft. Could have been. Don't think there's anything I could do about it, even if it was, though. But anyway, it's time to go test the stars. Oh, and while I'm here, by the way, I wrote down somewhere up there that the computer told me there's 7 levels to the elevator, and I wrote that down because I wanted to know if it matched the buttons, and I never looked. So it said 7 floors, and yeah, there's 7 buttons. From 0 to 6. Okay, so what the computer says matches up with the buttons. Good to know. I'm just gonna try running at this thing really fast, just like I did for the other one. Maybe if I run at it really fast enough, it'll finally break. It's not even creaking. One more try. Okay. I'm satisfied that that is not a solution. Alright. Oh, right, I have to actually assemble these. Well, that can't be right. Can it? No, that can't be right, because nothing can go down there. That might be right. It's kind of tricky. So what's the only thing that could actually go in there? Just this? This actually might work. That's not gonna work, is it? No! So close! Alright, well, this left side actually might be okay. What if we just reorient this side? So what, this would need to be... Well, that can't possibly be it. That'll never work. Promising. Yes, there we go. Is it? Oh, it's actually mirrored on each side, isn't it? It is! Right, if I looked at the fact that we had the same number of pieces of each type, then I guess I could have realized it had to be mirrored. Because if it worked on one side, then of course it'd work on the other. Okay, so this is the first star room that I've ever unlocked. And I worked damn hard for these stars. I worked really, really hard. So I wonder what is going to happen. I'm scared.
I see all. I know all. My power knows no bounds. And yet your will is free because you were made to be free. It is the very principle of your existence, without which the trials of this world would hold no meaning. To seek salvation must be your choice.
What is this place? Nine Star Star? These are puzzle rooms for gray pieces? There's the fan, which I've never used before, although I can kind of figure out what it does. Pushes you. Whoa! I didn't know it pushed me that far. Can I go back, please? This is weird. Damn it, how do I open these things? Look at that taunting me. Alright, well, I am going to explore this place in the next episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.